Hi, beauties and curls. It's MelissaQ. Welcome back. Thanks so much for coming in and taking a seat. And if you hadn't subscribed already, we would love for you to go ahead and hit that subscribe button and be a part of the MelissaQ family. Yes, here we have fun. We get lit on the channel. Okay. Today's video is going to be actually face full of impressions again, just because I want to talk about this baby in the video and show you guys how I use it and all of that kind of stuff. Now, the Anastasia Nicole Guerriero collaboration, this is her glow kit. We're gonna talk about this and And I actually have some other products. I have some Shea Moisture skincare and I actually have some of this. Like I said, the Shea Moisture skincare. And I have a couple of brushes that I want to come with you. So if you're interested in this video, then keep watching. Now, I know I have a hair fail. It's because of I used a product that I thought I was using the Moisture Mist by Smooth Naturals, and I use the Shine, and I use a little bit too much. And this is what happens when I kind of let go oil, water and oil overload. I should have just used that on my ends and then used it in my hair, but we're gonna work the frizz today. Okay, so I just wanted to show you guys this because this is a flat twist out fail because of my fault. Number one, because I'm not good at flat twists, but I have to try and practice. I want to come with some new styles on the channel, and I use the wrong products in my hair. So hey, we mess up too here on YouTube. So I wanted to show you this hair fail. I was trying to use the Nourishing Mist and I ended up using the Perfect Moisture Mist, which has a castor oil and it's a liquid, so you're supposed to shake it well. But this I use on my ends, or I use this as my oil, because this has oil and water in it. And really, you should, in my hair at least, I should only use this as my oil step of the lock method. I was just trying to spritz my hair to do the twist out. I should use this. Use the wrong product. So, yes. This is why I have frizz. Anyway, let's get straight into the video. Hi, beauties and curls. We are back with another video. And I love doing, I think, a face full of impressions. I wanted to show you guys also how the Anastasia Nicole Guerriero palette looks on, and I'm going to use that on my face and my eyes. So I actually got that from the early launch. This is my Fabulous Friday product that I'm going to talk about, but we're going to try some new products as well, and I'm going to let you know. Now, I was able to pick up the Shea Moisture skincare. Some of these, I like the face mask, I've tried already. And I have not tried the daily cleanser, and did I use the oil? I use these at night, but I want to use them during the day and see how they work. So we're going to try those. So let's just get started. First thing I'm going to do is moisturize my skin, which I am going to use this moisturizer and use it. I like to hydrate my skin first. Just do a mist, you know? So the first thing I'm going to do is use the face oil. And this is a daily hydration. It says overnight, but if you need some extra hydration, it said that you can use it during the day. And I'm going to mix it with my moisturizer. Okay, the first thing, I don't like how skinny, pump me some real moisturizer out. At night, this was super hydrating. The mask, insanely good. Now, this is a pretty penny though, but I'm gonna come with the full review on the skincare. You guys were asking about it on my Instagram. Super hydrated now. I'm gonna take a little bit under my eye. Okay, so I used these the other day and didn't get any fallout, but I think I'm gonna do my eyes first. This I got from $2 at Walgreens. This is from a Villians, you know those brush sets, the Villians? It was on sale. And it comes 4 in a pack, so I'm gonna try these brushes out today. They're all synthetic, so I'm gonna use, this is the Made for Matte. I'm gonna use this brush to set. I'm just gonna go in with that lighter shade. All of them are matte, so this is a creamy This is her E34 Blend Beauty Brush. So I am going to take this shade right here, the fourth one in the pan, and I'm just going to take it into the crease. And it's like a pinky nude. And the reason why I'm doing that is because I know today I want to kind of wear something pinky. I like this blending brush because it's kind of flimsy, but I like this a lot. And I feel like it's depositing just enough product. I want it right in that crease. And then I'm going to blow it out upward. Now I'm going to go into this reddish shade right here, this reddish brown. I like the shades in here. This black is like not extra black, but I can deal with it as long as, I mean, they actually put a black. You know, you can actually wet a black and make it darker. But they have a gray, a brown. I feel like this, it's, you know, for drugstore, it's met the need for matte shades. Now we're gonna go into the Anastasia. I used these on my eyes the other day and I really liked them. Looking firsthand, you can definitely see chunks of glitter, but I can tell you, I didn't get fallout, and I didn't use Fix Plus or anything, which I am gonna use today though. If you follow me on Snapchat, you would have seen that. I'm not gonna use Fix Plus, I'm gonna use just like some rose water. And I'm gonna use a flat shader brush. This one looks like a really good one to pack on color. So I'm gonna go into, yesterday I used Kitty Cat. Let's use Forever Young. We're gonna use Forever Young and Forever Lit in the inner corner, which is what I used yesterday. No, we used Forever Young yesterday. Let's use Daydream. Daydream is like a peachy color. So let's see. We're gonna take it and we're just gonna press it on the lid. Ooh, that's pretty. That's more of a peachy. Do we want peach? It's okay. Okay, that is with the brush. I bet you it could be more pressed if I use my finger. Yes. See, that is without, because the Fix Plus is not, I mean, the rose water is not on there anymore. Let's try our finger. It's still not intense as this one, so I am gonna go in with the spray. Yeah. So spraying it definitely is gonna intensify it the most to me. Just checking to see if I have any glitter fallout. And I see a little with Daydream. I see it like right in here. Okay, so far this is comfortable on my eye. Although I can kind of feel the glitter in here, to be honest with you. I want to go in with something on my outer corner. This brush. This is just a Mary Kay. This is a dual. This is a crease. This goes in your crease. And I really do like it. I'm going to use a chocolate shade of brown. And I'm using this shade in the Meat for Matte. I love that it has a mirror. Y'all see I'm switching mirrors. But I love that this has a mirror. I'm just going to take it in the corner and stop right there. The Meat for Matte. Just taking it. Blend it out. Yeah. This one is good for blending in the, like, out, back and forth. Yeah. Just a little bit of fallout. If you're going to use these on your eyes, I highly recommend not putting on your foundation yet. Because I am seeing fallout. I'm just going to pack a little bit more because I did lose some of that pigmentation going in. Okay, so let's move on to foundation. I'll finish my eyes up in a minute. Okay, so let me see in terms of primer. I like how my face feels moisturized with the Shea Moisture. Okay, so I don't see the Cover FX in here. So what I'm going to do is take this Tinted Moisturizer by Laura Mercier. It's a couple of shades too light, but I'm going to mix it with the Mary Kay and Bronze One because I think this is a little bit too dark for me. Yeah. And I'm going to make a cocktail. So I made my own foundation. Not really, but it's still Mary Kay. This is just a Laura Mercier Tinted Moisturizer on. And I want to see if I still love it. And this is the, is this the Luminous one? Yeah, Luminous Liquid Foundation. And this is in Bronze One. This is for normal to dry skin. Where's my beauty blender? Where's my beauty blender? Oh, there it is. Or my Real Techniques. I'm going to stop. I'm not going to go where you see the color correcting because that's where my concealer is going to go. I've been kind of like doing that so I don't get cake face lately because I feel like I've been getting cakey right in here. So I've been taking my concealer, I mean my foundation, and actually stopping. I used to love this foundation. So I want to see if I'm falling, if it's still something that I want to wear. Or am I done with it? I'm going to take all of that. And so far, I like it. I remember this being like medium coverage for me. It's a little bit still kind of orange. But Bronze One is my summer shade, like mix with something. Ooh, maybe I'll mix Born This Way with this because Born This Way is light and I am on the train for mixing right now. So far, I love how that looks. But remember, your foundation is going to really reflect what you've put under it. So if it's hydrating, you gotta get a really good finish. You should get a really good finish on a foundation that you like. But moisturizing is key because it's what helps the foundation not only stick, but absorb and look like skin. So we're gonna do some... I've been loving this. I've just been falling back in love with some products. I did not realize that I love the fact that this has a mirror. So I'm just going to take that chocolate. And just blend that. So now let's go in the inner corner with Forever Lit. I love this. That's that white shade right here. I'm going to take, I like to put a good amount because I'm not going to go any more into it. Okay. I got a lot on that brush. Oh, that is pigmented. I'll press it with my finger because it's kind of like lifted. Y'all, that like Forever Lit is no joke. I think we're going to go into Daydream, and let's try Daydream and Forever Lit just because I want to see how Forever Lit tops. So I use this Luxie. If you are heavy-handed, this just puts, to me, this is great for every day just because it does like the deposit. Okay, so see, that one is a bit chunky. The one I used yesterday, Kitty Cat, is not as chunky as Daydream. Although Daydream is pretty. I'm gonna take what's on the rest of this brush. It is. So what I do is I like to go in with a beauty blender and just kind of blend that in. It still has the wet look, but this does have kind of like that chunky glitter in it. It's not like the ultimate though. The ultimate was like crazy chunky. Like you could feel the texture. You can't feel the texture in this one. Okay, I'm going to use Forever Lit like right there. I'm trying to see if I have like a thinner, like a smaller brush. I'm going to dip it into it and just go right here. Yeah, I'm going to blend that in. I just want to go right there. Bit Forever Lit. I like it. It gives like an ethereal, like you're an alien. But I feel like it's a good topper. Like I would never use Forever Lit by itself. So basically I'm putting on my face what I used on my, that is like intense, like kind of intense, too intense for work. So I'm going to, let me show you how I'm going to like, now you think I'm intensifying it, right? But what, while it's wet, taking your beauty blender and just blending it makes it blend more into the skin, I feel. Like it gives more like a wet look, but it's still, legs. Looks like this is definitely not glow within. I think you can with some of these, but you have to be very, very careful. Like it's blending in, but you really have to like, while it's wet, work it. I like that actually better. Like pressing it into the skin. Okay, so I'm gonna pop on some mascara, put on a lip, and then we'll come back. Okay, so we are back. I actually really love my look. Like, this is like totally me. So using this palette is like worth it for me just because I'm gonna use it on my eyes and I'm gonna use it on my skin. And I like the combinations. I love this Forever Lit. Actually, you know, a woman being a woman of color, I thought that this was a bit like, oh no. But I love it for my inner corner and I like it to top it on top of other highlights, like a topper, like a highlight top. You know how you have a blush topper? This one to me is a great highlight topper. Just to put like right there, and then you have like a layer. Yes, me liking this gets an A+ for me. Okay, I really do like this this coconut line virgin coconut oil from Shea Moisture. I'm gonna continue to use it and then come back with a review. Because I think with skincare, it takes a little bit longer for you to really find out if you like it or not. This mask is great. If you don't get anything else, get this hydration mask. This daily hydration mask, this is amazing. I'm going to come with a full review, but definitely this first impression, this was amazing. I could tell that definitely the next day, it's highly, highly. If you have extra dry skin, that's what you want to get. If you want a moisture mask, and this was about $17, this is great. And it has, it's fair trade, made with natural ingredients. So that's good. made for matte. A+. I really do like this. I like how they blended. I feel like I got a high-end look with a drugstore product. Like, this is probably the best matte palette at the drugstore that I've tried yet. These brushes from SLMissGlam, I do like. I actually like this one for contouring. And this one is great for that blending, that inner corner. So these I like a lot. I'm probably going to look into her line. Like, when I like brushes like that, I'm like, let me see. Because these are brushes that I don't usually use, but these really worked well for me. Like, yeah. These brushes were worth the money. That's from that Villians. I don't even know who made these, but this is from Walgreens. I like those. Let's see what else. I think that's all. I told you about the Double Ego, so I've used this before. I really do like this. If you want a brown, and this is in Tasmania, I've used that quite a bit, but I just wanted to tell y'all. Okay, so I hope you guys enjoyed this look. I really like it. And I love the fact that I can use the Forever Lit as a topper. I feel like it's a great topper. At first, I was going to say, no, this is not for women of color. But I love using this on my inner corner. It has like an opalescent, I want to say, because it has like a blue shift. You'll see it in the swatches. It does contain like glitter. You can actually see the glitter in it. But I can tell you, it's not like the Glow Kit where it was chunky glitter. This is glitter that you can see. I did get a bit of fallout with Daydream, which I'll talk about, but for the most part, I love these are like creamy foils. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Don't forget to give it a thumbs up. Please subscribe if you hadn't already, and I'll see you in the next few days in another video. Bye, lovies.